guys, Julia here. It's been a hot second. Even though it may not feel like a hot second to you, it feels like a hot second to me. Things are looking a little bit different, and that's because I'm in my dorm room. I'm not at home anymore. So in case you missed my dorm tour last week, I am now filming in front of this beautiful tapestry, that's what it's called. I might be changing it around a little bit. If I feel rambunctious and crazy, I might add some shelves and stuff, but like, there are rules to a dorm room of what you can and can't have on your wall, so we're gonna figure it out, but for now, this is probably what we're sticking with. Today, as I'm getting back into the normal routine of doing videos, I wanted to answer a question that I've gotten a lot, and it's, how did I write 2 books in high school, and how did I get them published in such a short amount of time? So, I'm gonna be talking about it today. Well, my 2 books, The Scavenger and Missing Her, were both published when I was in high school. The Scavenger was published at the beginning of my junior year in November, and then Missing Her was published during my senior year in May. And if you know anything about the book writing and publishing process, you'll realize those are very close together. It seems like kind of a long time, it's over a year apart, but in terms of book publishing, it's really not, because it takes so long to get everything prepared and to actually write the darn book, it takes a long time. So, thinking back, yeah, it was pretty crazy that I published 2 books in high school, but I did. Let me just give you a quick rundown timeline-wise on how The Scavenger and Missing Her came to be and how long it took for each of them. The Scavenger, from the first point of me writing it to the actual publication, took about 1.5 years, which again, not a really long time when you're writing a book, but I feel like I need to explain where I was coming from at the time. So I had been writing for years. I started writing like full-length books when I was in first grade. My first grade full-length book was like 10,000 words, but to first grade me, that was very impressive. And I wrote book after book after book, and I would usually write the first draft or like the first 3/4 of a first draft, and I'd get into it, and I'd realize that there was some major flaw, or that there was just something that wasn't clicking, and I would put it aside. I had all of the excitement, I had all the energy, but I just didn't have the story that would be able to carry that energy into a full-length book. So I was trying my best to keep up with writing, and I was working hard to continue to improve upon my writing and all this stuff, but I was really waiting for what I called the book. I keep a journal, and sometimes I would go back over my writing journal and like look at my writing journey, and I kept saying like, I have like all this great like scenes and all these great moments that I want to include, but I just don't have the story to keep it there yet. Until The Scavenger came along. I came up with The Scavenger when I was a sophomore in high school, and I just took it and ran. There was something more potent about it, there was something deeper, and it was able to include all of those moments that I'd been dreaming about writing about. And it literally, as soon as I got the idea, the next day I wrote like it was like 2,000 words in a day, which again, like after just finishing Mandy Lynn's 10K challenge, that doesn't seem like a lot, but after not being able to write something without like putting it aside, that was just so exhilarating for me. So I banged out The Scavenger. I think the first draft took like 2 weeks. It wasn't very long. It was like 30,000 words, I think, but it was still, for me, and like, it was 30,000 in 2 weeks is pretty good. And I just was so excited to be writing something that meant something to me, that it was easy to write it and to edit it and to publish it in such a short amount of time. It did take a while to figure out how to go about the actual publication process, because once I had finished writing The Scavenger, I wanted to edit it properly, I wanted to go through all of the steps to make sure it was the best it could be, because as my day view, I wanted to make sure I was putting out something good into the world, and I didn't want to have to rush through it. So that took actually more of the time. While I was doing that, I was continuing to write and revise. And that was The Scavenger, November 13th. There you go. Missing Her was a little bit more complicated, because The Scavenger was released at the beginning of my junior year, because I wanted to get it done before I had to worry about SATs and standardized tests and blah blah blah. For Missing Her, I was like, no problem. I had started writing that actually while I was in the publication process of The Scavenger. So it had been with me a lot longer. The story had actually come to me while I was writing The Scavenger, and I kind of put it on hold until I had some more time to give to it. And then once The Scavenger was kind of set and done, I could run with that one. And I spent the whole summer completely like doing whole reworks and betas and all this stuff. And I came into my senior year going, yes, this is great. I'm gonna do all of this stuff for college and then that's it. We're all done, no problem. It's not that easy senior year. People who say that senior year is your easiest year didn't have the senior year that I had. Once I put in all of the college applications, that's great. But then there's the stress of waiting for college applications. There's the stress of having to put in your mid-year grades and sending those off to colleges. And a lot of times it's the big colleges that want your mid-year grades. So it's not like you can stop grinding after November 15th or whenever your last deadline is. You have to continue working. I was also stressed about AP tests, which if you're not familiar with AP tests, it's a standardized test where if you get a high enough score in a certain genre, you can actually skip forward in classes. So I was stressed about that too. It was a lot of work and a lot more work than I expected. And luckily I'd gotten a lot of stuff done for Missing Her beforehand, but there was so much more to be done. With The Scavenger, I didn't really know how to properly launch a book. I learned as much as I could with the publication process, but launching is less a you have to do this, this, and this, and it's more of feeling the genre of your book and feeling your audience and how to best get them intrigued. So that was something I had to figure out while I was publishing Missing Her and while I was trying to figure out the whole senior year thing. It was a lot. And it was funny because The Scavenger was actually so much easier to publish, even though I didn't really know what I was doing. But because I just had that liberation and like I didn't really have any expectations, I just did my best and it ended up turning out pretty good, I think. But with Missing Her, because The Scavenger was so well received, I now felt like I had to top that. And I wanted to make the launch the best it could be, and I wanted to make the cover the best it could be, so it was a lot of pressure. But I made it happen. So what's my biggest tip if you want to publish a book in high school, or if you want to go crazy like me and publish two books in high school? It's use every moment. Especially when you're in high school, I feel like there is so much time that's wasted, at least for me. Of course, like, you have to do schoolwork. That's not wasted time. Of course, you have to go to sports practices and do extracurriculars and all that stuff. Again, that's not wasting time, and I don't want you to think that that is. But as teenagers, it's so easy. If we're just tired or it's been a long day and we have a couple of hours, you just turn on Netflix and they automatically go to the next episode, or you go to YouTube and they're automatically recommending the next videos. And that's fine to relax for a little bit, but we're just drawn into it, into an endless cycle. And that was my biggest problem, probably freshman and sophomore year. I was involved in a lot, but I wasn't doing as much as I should or could. And that's also what drove me to write and to do something that was taking up my spare time in a way that was productive. So that's what I ended up coming out with. So all of those empty hours that I didn't spend on Netflix culminated in The Scavenger and Missing Her. I don't have a Netflix account anymore. Now and then I'll delete YouTube off my phone if I need to really get stuff done, because it really does work and you'd be surprised how much free time you have. I just want to clarify, if you're in high school right now and if you are doing your best and you don't have any spare time and you are just struggling or you're just trying your hardest, there's nothing wrong with that. It depends what school you're in, what personality you have, and just overall how your life is going. Because there's nothing that says that you should be doing this, this, or this at a certain time. If you're a writer and you love writing and you don't have time to write right now, there's nothing wrong with that. You find the moments that work best for you and you go with that. Just because I was able to go crazy and write two books during high school doesn't mean that that's the norm, doesn't mean that it's most likely healthy for a lot of people. I just was something I was able to do. Looking back, it was really crazy, but I just made it happen. So again, no matter where you are, if you are a lover of writing and of reading, you're doing a good job. It doesn't matter what you're getting done or not getting done, you're where you're supposed to be. So that's all I have for you guys today. I hope that answered some of your questions. If you have any others, please leave them in the comments below and I'll be happy to answer them. Thank you for stopping by. Bye.